Hi, thank you. That was a very inspirational talk. I'm very interested in the idea of other measures for national progress. You've talked about health. I'm also interested in the idea of maybe a gross national happiness measure. But the difficulty is the way that we understand increasing happiness is through economic development. And individuals, it's very difficult to say, I will be happy with less. So how do you change people's minds so that they will personally take that action?
好,
thank you.
好, 这一点很重要, 大家每一天都要吃饭, 如果说我们吃的饭, 很有滋味, 然后没有副作用,
flavorful, and if what we eat
那你就感觉到幸福啊,
and there's not a negative impact of
那这样的食物怎么样得来呢? 这样的食物不能靠经济发展得来, 经济越发展, 农业人口越少,
that is of this quality.
然后越是化学食品,
economic development. The more you develop as an economy, the worse the food.
大家知道啊, 在美国,
everyone knows that in the United States,
70%的抗生素,
70% of antibiotics
是给这个我们的鸡, 我们的牛, 我们的牲口吃的,
are used for cows.
70%的抗生素,
70% of antibiotics in the US is used.
然后我们的所有的农业, 90%几是化学种出来的,
of pesticides are created by hazardous chemicals.
如果说是
now if
把这个食物变成有机,
maybe
把更多的人口
organic,
转化为这个农业人口的话, 而不是现在一个人养活一百个人,
more closely with food, that we had less efficiency.
你的幸福水平肯定提高的,
being able to feed 100 people. I think that you'd be
你现在在工厂里面, 其实你蹲在这个农田里面劳作, 你的幸福感受, 我相信也会更高的。
I think that you, a factory worker isn't necessarily happier.
我们在车间里的那些流水线上面的那些工人,
we've got line workers in factories,
总是一个重复动作那种工人, 其实那是最最痛苦的, 连续这样工作几个小时, 那人只有发疯, 没有别的出路, 大脑都要摔, 都要摔腿,
your mind is going to go insane.
就是跟我们吃有关了。
And so that's just a simple example that is tied to quality of food.
如果说还有一点, 如果说我们更多人不是在,
if not more
在 business, 在搞销售, 而是去拉琴, 而是去画画,
if more of us,
如果他的画被你买到家里面去,
in business,
他拉琴的时候, 你把他请到家里面去听, 而不是听DVD, 那我想你的幸福感受也要高得多啊。
There are other elements of society, non-tangible elements, that we can enjoy that increase our quality of life.
如果你的小孩子不是犯了托儿所,
aren't in a daycare,
而是请了一个相对贫穷一点的人口的人来帮你带小孩, 你的小孩幸福得多啊。
But instead are cared for by somebody that you've brought in that cares for the kid, your kid's going to
非物质的方法有非常非常的多, 非物质的这个经济, 非物质的发展方式,
about life,
但他们大家不叫发展,
that inspire people,
其实那是发展,
and make people grow,
那是人类应该追求的一个发展。
And that's what we should try and work towards.
Another question, please. Yes, over here.
Thanks very much. I'm Chris Penny from Boston College. To follow up on the comment about government, in my experience, limited experience though it is, the Chinese government is actually probably more progressive on CSR issues, has better policy agenda than most other countries. I don't think the problem really lies with government. The issue really is, how do you create a culture in the Chinese business community that embraces this wonderful kind of vision you put forward? And particularly when we come to talking about publicly traded companies, I'm just wondering what your perspective or influences on the broader business community in China.
现在其实一切都
right now, actually,
都很晚,
maybe it's a little late.
如果说是一个40天以后, yeah, 哥本哈根要开会,
you know, in 40 days we've got Copenhagen.
如果说我们不转变一种观念,
we don't change,
我们还是用在发展的基础上面 去改变我们的这个能源的这个使用方式, 改变提高能源的这个运用技术或者效率, 或者说清洁能源更多的推广, 不解决问题的。 所以如果说是我们没有一种新的观念, 没有一种大胆的观念, 说国家站在国家的高度要来限制这个发展的话, 哥本哈根就是非常可笑的。
from a country level, we decide that we're going to make some limits.
不管大家认为我的话有没有道理，但是我想，如果是目前这种方式到哥本哈根去开会，其实是更加没道理的，更加可笑的。
Countries can set the limit.
那人类有没有办法呢？我觉得两件事情是可以做的。一件事情是从小学生开始教会他们一种新的生活态度，不是简单的三个字"美国梦"就可以解决他们的这个未来。
We can educate our young children to tell them that there is.
如果我们总是把美国梦当做一种追求，全世界都把美国梦当做一种追求，所有的技术都等于是白，都是白搭的。
All of the technology that we can have on clean energy is useless.
那第二种呢
Secondly,
那就是气候急剧变化，灾难急剧发生，发生的越早可能我们醒悟的越早，没有别的办法，只有是从小学生教起，或者是早一点来灾难，因为我们人类没有办法了，等到我们都发展到了，等到我们的空气里面弥漫了这个1000 ppm 的二氧化碳的时候，等到我们呼吸都要戴氧气面罩的时候，一切都来不及了。
So far we've talked about business, we've talked about government. What about consumers, particularly in China? Where do you see some of the drive, where do you see some of the opportunities to both affect behavior, to affect business, and to think about this as a driver for future behavior?
我现在觉得主要是这个
right now it's primarily
从国家层面的这个错误思想。因为我们现在在讲拉动消费，两年以前我们中国的口号是叫做节约型经济，构建节约型经济，现在是喊拉动消费，以消费作为爱国的一种标志，这非常危险的，以发电多，以发电多，以煤的消耗多，作为一个喜讯，在报纸上面写出来，非常危险。
Saying that these things are glorious in the paper, and this is a dangerous attitude to give the public.
啊，我们这些中国人天天在报纸上看得到这样的信息。
In China, you can see
很莫名其妙的新闻
all day long, and I think it's bizarre.
就是很危险。
And I find it dangerous.
经济危机给了我们很多很多借口。
So much of such a big excuse.
其实中国是真的没有发生经济危机，中国只是出口，单纯出口的企业有一些影响。可是我们大家用经济危机这样的一个借口，大规模的、大力的刺激了基础经济，刺激了投资，刺激了消费。连农村里有些没有电的这个地方，那个冰箱都卖到家里面去了。难道烧木炭可以点着冰箱吗？